Hello and welcome to another tutorial. In this video, I'll be showing you how to make a hooded cloak for your model horses. Since I know hoods can be a bit tricky, so this video could hopefully be helpful. The materials are the fabric that you're going to make the cloak from, scissors, a pencil or something else to mark on the fabric, wire, pliers and wire cutters, needle and thread, although you can use glue instead. So, at the beginning, I'm folding the fabric like this, so it's long enough to cover the whole horse, and then I cut out this rectangle, and it should look something like this. Just important not to cut it too short. Now I'll be making the incision for the neck. Okay, it works like this. It should be long enough to cover the front of the horse too. And so now I'll take care of those long sides. I decided to go for sort of heel length. So I just cut them, making sure it's equal length on both sides, so it's not longer on neither of the sides. Now I have something like this, and the next step will be doing something with the rims. First I made them even and round, also made some space for the tail. I decided to sew the rim. You don't have to do this, or just use glue to secure the edges, but I've decided to sew it. I'm done with it and it looks like this. Now the time has come to make the hood. First of all, I mark where the neck begins and where the ears are to make it high enough, if that makes any sense. Then I measure the length of the incision that goes around the neck, so it's long enough to go around the horse's neck. And then I sort of connect those lines in a hood-like shape. The longer you make the back end that I'm drawing right now, the deeper will the hood be. And once I cut that out and sewed it in, I realized that it was kind of too small, so I went with another one. Flip right sides in, then sew it and glue it, and turn inside out. Here's the size I was using for this Akalteke horse, so go for slightly bigger than you think. Now I just sew it to the coat, and well, we're almost done. You could use Velcro to make it close on the horse, or button, just anything really, it's up to you. I'll be showing you some strange kind of wire buckle that I came up with. I'm starting by making this like a circle, then adding the loop that the hook will grab onto, and then I'm making two more circles like in the video. And for the other part, I'm just making one circle and bending the end to make a hook. The only thing that's left now is to attach them. Hot glue would be good enough. I tried to sew them on though, worked quite well. If you want to make sure the horse won't be scratched by the hook, just place this bigger part farther on the side, and then it would close like this without touching the horse. So I hope this was helpful and at least a little bit understandable. I hope it was just enjoyable and nice to watch. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you had fun and see you in my next video.